I'm Sam Hocker. I'm a veterinary medical oncologist here at Evolution Veterinary Specialists. Oncology is similar in the veterinary world as it is in people, which is essentially anything related to cancer, whether that's malignant or benign. I think from an owner perspective, they see it as, you know, obviously very concerning and worrisome for them. Often though, it does depend on what type of cancer we are dealing with. And I think other things that take into account is a lot of people take their own personal experiences or people that they know from the human side and try to kind of bring that into veterinary medicine. And there are a lot of differences in how we approach treatments and our pets compared to on the human side. It does depend on type of cancer we're seeing in regards to what owners will see at home. Oftentimes what owners will see at home are very kind of vague clinical signs. It might be anything from they have a slightly decreased energy level, they might have a decreased appetite, it could be vomiting, diarrhea. Sometimes the patient's actually totally normal, it's just that maybe, for instance, like they have big lymph nodes, which is not normal for them, but otherwise they're doing everything else. So clinical signs are usually not very specific for certain types of cancers. It can be related to other types of issues. It's just a matter of finding out if it is cancer causing those clinical signs. It is harder to determine the true incidence in dogs and cats sometimes compared to people, whereas if you have an issue, you will go see your doctor and it's reported. In veterinary medicine, we do not have a good central database to actually track the true incidence, but it's probably very similar in a lot of cancers. Dogs specifically often get lumps and bumps kind of all over their skin and in their subcutaneous tissue, which oftentimes are usually lipomas, so benign fatty masses that dogs get. When we have dogs that have skin masses, most of them are usually not aggressive cancers. They're usually just these fatty masses that they get that don't cause a lot of issues. However, us as veterinarians cannot tell you that they are benign or malignant by just touching the tumors with our hands. Usually further testing is needed to truly determine if that mass or tumor is malignant or it's benign. And so that's really important to know. The other thing is that, you know, if there's ever a concern, have a veterinarian check them out. Cats are a different story in that if there's any skin mass or skin tumor or anything like that on a cat, that is usually not normal. They can have benign skin lesions or skin tumors, but they are not normal in cats like dogs, where they just get these kind of fatty masses. Cats do not get that. So any skin mass or subcutaneous mass in a cat should be evaluated by your veterinarian. It's important to, you know, overall, again, tell the veterinarian everything that's going on that you're concerned about, whether or not that the skin issue is related to the things you're seeing at home. You know, they may not be linked, but it's still really important to give all that information. Any skin lesions or masses or tumors on the skin should be evaluated and at least tracked so that you know that if they're getting bigger, we at least have a measurement to know that over time. So usually kind of our first step is we might do what's called a fine needle aspirate, where we just take a syringe needle and collect some cells out of the mass and submit that. And that's kind of our initial testing because it's very non-invasive and doesn't cause a lot of issues. So that's kind of our first step to determine if we think we need to do further testing. Again, it does depend specifically on what type of cancer it is. Usually kind of our pillars of treatment options that we have, our first one, if we can, is surgery. So remove the tumor if possible. That gives us usually our best outcomes in most types of cancers. But in some cancers where it is not feasible to do surgery or surgery is not indicated, then we might do something like recommend radiation therapy or possibly chemotherapy for those patients. Remember, early detection and evaluation are essential when it comes to skin tumors. If you have any concerns about your pet's health, please do not hesitate to reach out to our team. Let's ensure our pet's well-being together.